want you up, up, down, down. We got Miss Bliss. We got Brett Matthews.
That's me.
With a Z.
With a Z.
We're playing Kingdom Hearts 3, but this time we're going to the toy box.
Ooh, I love a good toy box. You
I
know
love
what I'm
Toy Story.
I'm a big toy guy. That's kind of my thing. You're the video game guy, I'm the toy guy. You're the poser. You know what I'm saying? We all represent something.
This guy.
You represent the video game community, the toy community, the fakers, you know, the people who pretend to like things. You know what I'm saying? We were just talking about your Club 33 Mickey ears.
Yeah, so I have Mickey ears from Club 33.
Have you been?
No, because I didn't have a Twitter hookup to get there.
Mine was not through Twitter.
Sorry, Instagram.
It wasn't Instagram. I've been inside. I have the ears. They're on display in my toy room. Oh,
this is
great.
Television racks.
I have all these toys set up in my toy room. Mint.
Really?
Great condition.
Do you have any of these toys?
I have a Woody and a Buzz, and I actually have a Buzz Lightyear outfit that I have that I got from Disney. I have the jacket. I was so excited because I got it on my birthday, and it was like $50 for like this little sweatshirt, and I was like, damn, that's kind of steep for a sweatshirt. But then after I bought it, I realized that there was a laser in it. You push the button, and it goes,
that's pretty cool.
Like a laser, right? Well worth the money.
For Christmas, my girlfriend Chelsea got me the Ham figure, the original one from the mid-90s. I don't want like the newer one. I want the original one, and I was kind of impressed that she went on eBay, and she got the right one. I was very proud of her.
I gotta go back and watch
three. Oh my gosh,
three's
three,
good. I might go back and watch them all.
You. Yeah. Three wrecks you.
And
you,
and
you haven't checked that Toy Story Land at Disney World, have
you? No, I haven't been to Disney in a while.
You gotta go.
It's so cool. There's a scene where they're like, get ready to go on the incinerator in three.
Spoiler alert.
Like messes you up.
Spoiler alert. Now tell me about this.
It's been out though. It's been out
for like 10 years.
I know.
But it's like that moment they all like join hands and they're ready to like
die.
Go. But then it doesn't happen.
After you saw this for the first time, because we were younger, did you think that your toys did this?
Yes and no. See, I always, like, I was young enough to think that, like, toys can come alive and, like, all that stuff. And then when I saw Toy Story 2 with Jessie, I remember when she sang that song, When Someone Loved Me, you know, like, when somebody loved me. And, like, the girl, like, moves on and, like, abandons Jessie. That night, I went home, and I was very young, mind you, and I put all my dolls in my bed and, like, slept with them. I was just like, I was like, I love all of you.
Where are they now?
Actually, I gave them all to my cousin Skyly, so they're still being used.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah, I still have my original doll that I loved, Hannah. I still have her. Like, I still have like some original toys that I'll never get rid of.
Are any of the toys in your collection originals? Like from when you were?
I'm an adult collector. Okay, so listen. So like, I'm not like you remind me of someone like Sam Roberts. You know Sam Roberts? He's someone who has his childhood toys all beat up, missing fingers on display. Not me. Listen, I have my originals.
Why am I missing fingers?
My LJN wrestling figures from like the 80s. I have them all. My childhood ones. Yeah, like I'm chewing on the fingers as a little kid. I have them, but I'm an adult collector. They're not on display. Okay, they're in my parents' basement in some toy box. Mine are mint. They smell beautiful. Okay, they're nice and shiny. Like it's like light mint.
They're all mint.
They're mint.
Mint. Oh,
yeah.
Teacups.
Oh, teacups. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I love the teacups.
So I'm controlling this.
One thing we both have, I think, we both have matching teacup coffee mugs, don't you?
I do not have any.
You don't have any of the teacup ones?
No,
I thought you did.
I don't drink tea. I'm a coffee guy.
No.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no crap. But they come in coffee mugs.
It's a Disney thing.
I thought you had them.
Okay, so when I press Y
this is really cool.
Now I'm gonna.
Right?
I ran out. Never mind. I was dumb.
Boom.
Okay. This is a thing. Oh,
so
I've got a new weapon.
This is really great.
Question.
Yes.
Your opinion. Pizza Planet better in Orlando or LA? Anaheim.
What does that mean?
Did you like it better? Have you been to both?
The one in Hollywood Studios is the one that's not there anymore.
Yes.
Now it's like the Muppet Rat place.
Yeah, Ratatouille.
No.
Oh my God.
It was
two different things. Oh my God. No. It's like Rizzo the Rat from the Muppets, not Ratatouille.
I thought it was Ratatouille.
Oh my.
But I haven't been since it changed from Pizza
Planet. Poser.
What's the rat's name in Ratatouille?
What is his name?
I never saw Ratatouille.
What?
I can't say it.
I just recently watched Ratatouille.
I heard it's very good.
It's really good.
It's Remy, actually?
Remy?
Remy?
Is that right?
Remy? I don't know. I can't remember.
Remy? Okay, yeah.
I think for a one-day experience, Disneyland is better than Disney World. For one-day experience.
Yes.
But if you're going to do like a vacation with your family, like 5 days, whatever, you got to go to Disney World. There's just not enough at Disneyland.
Okay, question. So since you guys have both been to Disney World so much, sometimes when you go, well, every time when you go, you see people who have their kids.
Right.
What do you think the most viable age is for a kid to go to Disney? Because, like, I feel like these parents are freaking out, and they're stressed out, and they've got a kid in a stroller. They're not going
to
remember it anyway.
I think you have to wait till they're through that, like, breakdown stage.
Four and older. Because, like, four and older. I think if I was any older, I would have remembered more. But the only thing I remember, like, I was posing with Captain Hook, and he, like, held my ponytail up. Posing.
Yeah.
But, like, the people that portray the characters are really freaking good at it, too. Because I remember I met Tinkerbell on my birthday a couple years ago, and she was, like,
to the same size?
Yeah. That was my goal. I wanted to be Tinkerbell at Disney one day.
I want to be Tigger.
Yeah.
When I'm done with WWE.
Why Tigger?
Tigger's one of my favorites, and I just want to be under the costume and bring joy.
Then why'd you give me crap for staying at Crystal Palace?
No, Crystal Palace is great, but it's like...
I feel like if you want a picture of Tigger...
I think I said Piglet.
You said Piglet and Tigger.
Yeah, Crystal Palace is okay, but...
What, so are you a big Winnie the Pooh guy?
I do like Winnie the Pooh a lot.
But Tigger just stands out for you.
Yeah. This is a great game. Look at the graphics here.
It's incredible. It's incredible. There's a cutscene. They're all talking about stuff, just like we're talking about stuff. We're about to go outside. What's your favorite place to stay when you go to Disney? Being an AP, annual pass holder.
Right.
Do you stay at a hotel there, or do you go back home?
I live like a half hour, 45 minutes away, but sometimes I go just to take advantage of extra magic hours.
Yeah,
which is like, if you stay at the resort, you can get into the park like an hour early.
Or an hour later.
Sometimes, like, I want to do Animal Kingdom, you know, before it opens at Rope Drop.
Yeah. What is Rope Drop?
After he said he doesn't do Rope Drop.
What is Rope Drop?
Rope Drop is like, there's literally like a rope.
Like, when they do the parade at night.
No, it's in the morning. So like, let's say the park opens at 8 o'clock. They'll they'll let you in to a certain point, and there'll be like a rope. Okay. And then like 7:50, they'll drop the rope and everyone runs to the best ride.
Can we just talk about how you said you don't do rope drop?
No.
And you're like, I go for the magic hours, like, no, rope drop.
Well, for that particular instance, I wanted to do Pandora and not wait like a 5-hour line for
it. I like the themed ones. I like the kitty-themed ones. No, like the kitty-themed ones. Like, I like
No. I like the movies. The movies one is good. Has a Mighty Ducks pool.
Yeah.
Very dated.
Ooh. It's very
dated. But so good.
It's like a Mighty Ducks pool, like an ice rink. I love it. I was just there this year. I made sure I stayed in the Mighty Ducks building.
I can't remember who,
No one who requested. Can I please stay at the Mighty Ducks building? I requested it.
Why have they not remade that yet?
Because the rooms are themed like that, too.
Yeah.
Like, if you're in that building, the room is, like, themed.
Is there, like, hockey sticks in there? Slapshot?
I'll show you a picture of the pool.
Okay. It's really cool. My favorite though, like I like, it's either music or sports. They have the duck, like DuckTale themed pool.
Mm.
And they have all the characters, and they have like fountains coming out of the ducks and stuff.
I think at Art of Animation in the pool, like you can go underwater and like you hear like Nemo and everybody.
That's cool.
Under the water?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
That's cool.
I want to stay in the Cozy Cone. There at Art of Animation.
What is the Cozy
From
Cone?
Cars.
Oh, okay.
Cozy Cone, Mater. He's like, Mater. I live at the Cozy Cone. And that's it.
You guys are in. I'm jealous that I don't know all of this.
I'm just a diehard, you know?
So have you done Keys to the Kingdom?
I don't know what that is.
So, okay.
He's a diehard.
So this is the one thing that I know. So what did you do? Maybe like 11, 12 years ago. So they take you in before the park opens up. And they walk you through a bunch of the stuff, and they're showing, you know how when you first walk in, if you like go in and go to the right, there's like nothing over there but like some shops where they have like all the windows set up.
Yeah.
They're explaining to us like how printed on the windows are like very important dates in Disney history and like people who help like put these bricks together and stuff like that. So like it's really cool. And then they give you a special pin, the Keys to the Kingdom pin.
That's
and they
cool.
take you underground, and they said that underneath Disney, there's enough space to house 3 times the amount of people that will fit in Disney.
Oh, right, because everything's like on the story above, really. It's all built, right.
Yeah.
So it's like underneath there, so like if a character has to go somewhere, they can go down there and then get in the go-kart and then go wherever they need to go. But it's wild.
That's awesome.
I don't think I'd want to go like behind the scenes stuff. I feel like that would kind of ruin
the
magic for me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I love it. This is great.
This is so cool.
So we got Woody helping us out now.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think in this we're gonna get a chance to do the one of the big moves. So I'll alert you to when that is happening.
Did you ever play Donald Duck's Going Quackers?
No, what is that?
It was on PlayStation. It was one of my favorites.
Quackers?
Yeah. Donald Duck Going Quackers.
No, I've never heard of that.
I used to love Aladdin for Super Nintendo.
Ooh,
that
what
was
a
like
game.
One of the best games.
What a game.
I love that.
And a hard game too. It was like
very
that
hard.
And Latin Lion King were both really hard. But really fun. And now kids get to play Kingdom Hearts.
This game is awesome.
I know, it's sick. I love how it has a mixture of characters. It's not just one theme.
Here we go.
Ooh.
What?
That's awesome.
That's cool.
What? It's hard to control. I
was gonna say, where are you going?
I'm trying to hit this one guy. Here we go. We'll just do this.
What he's like? Oh, he grabs onto his hat. It was great.
So yeah, a lot of the things after you build up enough attacks and stuff, you get bigger attacks like that.
It's very cool.
Let's see where we're supposed to go. Okay, so with y'all's love of everything Disney,
right,
and going to Disney World, Disneyland, what would you say to someone who has never been to any of these places? How would you explain?
I would make them talk to me first so I can plan their trip to make sure that they're not like waiting in lines all day. It's all about the proper planning.
You call all of us hookups.
No. It's all about, stop it, okay? A couple times I use them in emergency situations.
What's an emergency situation?
Like if I can't get to Club 33, you know what I'm saying? Or if I need to get to the front of Slinky Dog's coaster and don't want to wait on the 3-hour line.
That's an emergency, man.
Yeah.
They don't just know you
big
there
emergency.
At this point.
But typically, you know, like the fast passes that you can use on My Disney Experience, you get three, like let's say you go to Magic Kingdom, you get three fast passes. You can book it in advance.
Well, it depends
if you're staying on property, then 60 days in advance. And then you can make it a fake reservation and then cancel later and get like even more in advance. But it's working the system, brother.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Fake reservation, cancel.
So for instance, like for Magic Kingdom, right? Like the parking is like pretty expensive, right?
You know they're not gonna let you do this now after this.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, we should talk about
okay.
that.
Okay. All right, sweet. So we got to experience some of the stuff in Toy Story. So
that was a great game.
It looks amazing.
That's great.
Looks awesome.
You get to experience all these sweet Disney characters. So of the stuff we saw, like some of the stuff in Hercules, some stuff in Toy Story, what kind of Disney feelings does it evoke seeing like a Buzz Lightyear on screen in a video game?
I mean, it makes me want, I need to go to Disney this
Buzz
week.
Is my
I need
favorite.
To go. I need to go this week. I was just there last week, but I need to go this week. I need to just go for a little bit.
Me too.
Just for a little
you
bit.
Go?
I went on Thursday.
Oh, okay.
I did three parks in one day. Just saying.
Is this a pretty much an every week thing?
Every couple weeks, you know?
I go every few weeks, but I don't do like three parks in one day. I like to go to one park and then spend the whole day there.
And enjoy it.
Yeah, enjoy it.
Take it in.
Get my
you're not,
Starbucks.
You're not opposed.
You know, like, exactly.
You're getting the experience.
Yeah.
You say someone who goes to multiple parks in one day,
you know, just to try to get their passes set up, you know? It's just about the rides. It's just about the rides.
That's
not
true at all.
Experience.
I'm about the experience.
He doesn't stay for the fireworks. You know what I
mean? I do stay for the fireworks, but when you go like all the time, like
you
can't.
You just said you left during the fireworks.
No, because you can't watch them every time.
So what if we guys? Okay. What if we come together? And she
I know.
Can sit
I don't understand
you.
Why it's a feud.
She
why can't
can,
we just?
She
can,
it's not a feud.
She can bring you Mulan in a Goofy movie, and you can help her get into Club 33.
I can't help her.
That.
No.
He his contacts are his contacts.
Yeah. Is that like no?
All right. Well, thank you guys for being on. Appreciate it. That's Kingdom Hearts 3. It's available now at PS4, Xbox One. So go check it out because you know you've been waiting on it anyway. Now you got some Disney knowledge on top of a sweet Disney game. So until next time, make sure you always and forever keep it tight.